स्टार्ट लेक्चर 5 बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स। सी नाउ लेक्चर 5 ग्राम एटॉमिक मास। हियर वेरी सिंपल थिंग इज व्हेन द एलिमेंट्स मास ऑफ एलिमेंट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन ग्राम। मास ऑफ एलिमेंट इज एक्सप्रेस्ड इन ग्राम्स, इट इज नोन एज ग्राम एटॉमिक मास GAM, एंड इट इज ऑल्सो टर्म्ड एज ग्राम एटम और मोल एटम। It is also termed as atom or mole atom. Now you see the formula. These formulas are being used for solving the problems. You see, number of atoms are mole atoms. Number of atoms are mole atoms. This is very simple. Mass of an element upon gram atomic mass. Now you see, mass of an element in gram is equal to number of atom into gram atomic mass. You are well aware with this that number of atoms in 1 gram is equal to Avogadro number 6.02 into 10 to power 23. Now in 1 gram, if it is equal to this one, then for substance what will happen? Number of atoms in substance will be equal to number of gram of atom. Very clear. And 6.02 into 10 to power 23. Now you see the formula. Number of gram of atom is what? Number of gram of atom is equal to mass of an element mean mass upon gram atomic mass. Now you put here number of gram of atom equal to mass upon gram atomic mass. Now you see 6.02 into 10 to power 23. You see number of atoms in 1 gram of element will be what? 6.02 into 10 to power 23 upon atomic mass. Now mass of one atom of element in gram equal to gram atomic mass upon 6.02 into 10 to power 23. This is about gram atomic mass. Means when the element's mass is being expressed in gram, it is termed as gram atomic mass GAM or gram atom or mole atom. Very simple. This is to understand here a number of atom in 1 gram equal to 6.02 into 10 to power 23. Now we will see the gram molecular mass GMM. Actually that is equally important to solve the problems related to Avogadro number as well as to calculate the number of atoms in entities. Actually maybe atom, maybe molecule, maybe anyone entity we can calculate by these formulas. Now I am going to see the next head, that is the gram molecular mass. You see gram molecular mass. See, now next is the gram molecular mass. Gram molecular mass. It is termed as GMM. See, I simply stated that when the element's mass in gram is there expressed, it is termed as gram atomic mass. Now, if the substance mass, molecules mass is being expressed in gram, then it is termed as gram molecular mass or gram molecule or mole molecule. See, very simple. In case of gram atomic mass, you saw GM, it was expressed in gram mass of element. Now, gram molecular mass, very simple, gram molecule or mole molecule it is termed as, and the molecule mass or the substance mass is being expressed in gram. So, number of molecules or mole molecules is equal to mass of molecule or leave here mass of substance you can put upon gram molecular mass. Very simple this is. And now next is, you can see this is gram molecular mass. But the number of molecules are mole molecules, mass of substance in grams upon gram molecular mass. Now you can see this one, second formula. Mass of substance in grams. What will happen? This will be number of molecule into GMM. Number of molecule into G, sorry, GMM. So, gram molecular mass for the molecule, for the substance, we are expressing the weight in the gram. So, it is termed as number gram molecular mass as well as gram molecule or mole molecule. The formula, first number of molecule or mole molecule mass of substance in gram upon GMM. Mass of substance, this is clear, it will be cross multiplication. So now this is clear. Now we will start numericals. So numerical we will start from some easiest to tough one. Numericals we will take here, and it would be kind of competitive also. So first we are going to start the numerical C, and here I want to state one very important thing is, sometimes you will find that these concepts are being utilized in numericals, and sometimes you will find also that these numericals are making clear to you conceptually. So see the concepts. Now we are going to start numerical, at least one two numerical we will take today, then we will go like. Now objective type of numericals we are going to consider. Okay, now I'm going to write first numerical. You see, numerical 1. Numerical 1. Okay, now you see, numerical 1 we are going to write. A flask contains 2 into 10 to power 13 molecule of CO2. A flask contains 2 into 10 to power 13 molecules of CO2 to this 1.5 into 10 to power 14 to this 1.5 into 10 to power 15 14 molecules of CO2 are added. The number of molecule in this flask, the number of molecule in this flask is now. See, this is the numerical, very simple numerical. Understand this, very simple numerical, and we will cover actually number of commutative numericals. So please take care about this. A flask contains 2 × 10⁻³ molecules of CO2. To this we are adding 1.5 × 10⁴ molecules of CO2 are added into this. The number of molecules in this flask is now what? These are objective type. Answer A, given 3.5 × 10⁻³. Answer B, given 3.5 × 10⁴. Answer C, given 1.7 × 10⁴. Answer D, given none of these. None of these. Now you see, this number is given, this number is given, we have to, and this is very simple, one flask they are telling, and here we are adding one, then second, it means this is very simple, we have to add the values. So number of molecule in the flask is now what? Number of molecules in flask will be what? You see now, see, 2 × 10⁻³ plus 1.5 × 10⁴. Now you see, this is very simple. 2 × 10⁻³ plus 15 × 10⁻³. Now what will happen? 17 × 10⁻³ means this is equal to 1.7 × 10⁴. Means your answer will be C. Correct answer is C. Now see, this is very simple. A flask contains 2 × 10⁻³ molecules of CO2. We are adding 1.5 × 10⁴ molecules of CO2. Then what will be the total numbers in the flask? This is important question. This is important question. Now you see what? We are simply adding this one. Now see, this type of questions you will get. Addition is there. Subtraction is there, round off the figure, then give the answers like this. So this is very simple. Now 1.7 × 10⁴, answer C is correct answer. Now we are going to see the second numerical. Clear? This is clear. Now we are moving to second numerical. Going to start now numerical number 2. Similar kind of, you can see numerical two. Now you see, a flask contains 3 × 10⁻⁙ atoms of helium. from this 6.6 into 10 to power 15 atoms of helium are removed. The flask now contains atom of helium. Answer A, minus 3.6 into 10 to power 16. Answer B, plus 3.6 into 10 to power 15. Answer C, 2.3 into 10 to power 16. Answer D, none of these. Now you see, you will solve in the same manner. Flask contains number of helium atoms equal to what? What is this? 3.0 into 10 to power 16 minus 6.6 into 10 to power 15. Now this will be equal to 30 into 10 to power 16 minus 6.6 into 10 to power, sorry, this will be 15. Then you take this 2.34 into 10 to power, sorry, 30 minus 6.6 is equal to 23.4 into 10 to power 15. This will be equal to what? Round off this one. 2.3 into 10 to power 16. 2.3 into 10 to power 16 we are getting. This is actually, you can say, better. This is actually, we can say simply rounding off. Clear? Rounding off the last digit. No issue. So by this means, we can solve this problem. A flask contains 3 into 10 to power 16 atoms of helium. From this 6.6 in 10 to power 15 atoms of helium are removed. The flask now contains atom of helium. How much? Flask contains, this will be minus from this. This is taken out. 6.6 into 10 to power 15. This will be 30 into 10 to power 15. 6.6 into 10 to power 15. Now 23.4 into 10 to power 15. Round off the last digit, 2.3 into 10 to power 16 means the answer C will be correct. Answer C is the correct answer. Now, this is kind of important and usually we are getting in competitions. So, with some more numericals, I would be there with the coming lecture. Thank you.